Hey everybody, it's Tallboy here, and it's been a long time since, I don't know, sometime last winter that I made a washer video. There's been a little bit of reason why, but today we're going to feature the 1978 Maytag. This past winter I had some issues with it. Basically what the problem was it didn't want to agitate. I thought it was, I mean, I could hear when it would go to agitate the belt slipping on the pulley. I could hear it chirping. And I thought that it was just that the belt had worn out. I had replaced it, I don't know, years ago, but I hadn't replaced it in a long time. And so I got new belts for it and put new belts on and made sure the tension was set right on them and everything. And then tried to run it, and it was doing the same thing. It wasn't agitating, and the belt was chirping. And so I, at that point, had to, you know, had it full of water, and I couldn't get under, you know, I couldn't move it very well. So thankfully, even though it wouldn't agitate, it would spin, and so I was able to basically put it into, like, you know, spin mode and spin the water out of it and drain it out. And so I was able to get it emptied out. And then I took it and checked the not the motor pulley, but the main, like, transmission pulley. And it's, you turn the pulley one way and it spins, you turn it the other way and it agitates, and it did not want to turn the other way. It was really, really stiff. And so I did some online research. I was like, holy crap, I don't know what's going on with this. I did some online research on automaticwasher.org and found out that most likely what my problem was on the main shaft coming up out of the transmission is a bearing that's up fairly high that supposedly, I guess, it only gets lubricated when the machine goes into spin mode, but if the oil gets thick over years or whatever, that can kind of help prevent that bearing from getting lube. And it can, you know, if it doesn't get lube, it can bind up and seize up. And apparently that's what happened, was that bearing was getting really seized up. And the consensus was the process to fix that permanently would be to replace the transmission. But this machine takes the you know, the old style long stroke transmission, which they don't make anymore. I could convert it to the short stroke transmission that went in the machines from the 90s, but that would make it something that it wasn't meant to be in the first place. And so I looked for, you know, used transmissions for it, and there were three of them on eBay at the time that I looked. One was just some random person had one on sale for like $125, but it didn't really say anything about it. Didn't even say whether it worked or you know, anything about it. The other two were listed by Lorraine Furniture and Appliance in Ohio. And he had one that was a pull from a working machine. It was, you know, nothing had been done to it or whatever. It was like $250, I think. And then he had another one that he had completely gone through. This is Eugene at Lorraine Furniture. He had completely gone through it and then rebuilt it, and it came with a warranty and everything. And that one was like $400. And I didn't really even want to spend the like $125 for the one that was just, you know, the random seller on YouTube that didn't say anything about it. So I started to say, you know, well, what can I do to fix this one? There's really nothing wrong with the transmission, just that one bearing was seized up. And I saw someone post, and they said that they had saved many machines this way, especially since you can't get the transmissions anymore. And it's maybe not a permanent fix, but it's It's probably saved a bunch of machines that otherwise would have gone to the scrapyard. He said to basically disconnect all the hoses and everything and then flip the machine upside down on its top and let it sit there for, he said, for like, I don't know, I can't remember now, like a month or something, upside down, and let the oil from the transmission run down that tube and lubricate that bearing. I wasn't going to let this sit upside down for a month, but I flipped it upside down, and I actually had it upside down for about 4 hours. And every hour or two, I'd come down and turn that pulley some to try to see if it would start to loosen up. And it was, you know, after an hour, it was still tight. And 2 hours, it was still tight. After 3 hours, it seemed like it was getting a little easier to turn. And after 4 hours, it loosened up quite a bit. It's still not as loose as it should be, but it had loosened up quite a bit. And so I decided that I would flip it back over and plug it in and see what it would do, see if it would start agitating and stuff. And so I did that. I flipped it over, I reconnected it, filled it up just a small load, level of water, and started it going, and it filled up. And then when it started to agitate, initially it was agitating a little slow, and then it's like all of a sudden it's like it just let go and it just took off and went, you know, like full speed agitation, and it's been agitating great ever since. So for whoever that was, I saw that article on automatic washer about flipping it upside down one time, and then I could never find it again. Thank whoever it was that posted that tip. But I tried it and it worked, and it saved this machine. So we're going to do a video on this machine, what I have. Today is I've got a brand new set of sheets right there, and I want to put them on the bed, so I need to wash them before they go on the bed. They're just plain regular old white. They're like polyester cotton blend sheets, and we're going to be using the Arm & Hammer Complete detergent. And so let me get that in the washer and I will be right back. All right, I've got it. Everything's all in the machine. I'm going to run a hot wash with a warm rinse. And over here we got it set on the regular wash, and we got the extra large load. We'll let it go with that. And see if I can zoom back out here. There we go. And so we've got the Arm & Hammer detergent. We've got the Snuggle Exhilarations Lavender and Vanilla Orchid scent, or flavor, or whatever you want. Just wash freshness for 100 days. And so that's in there. And after it's been agitating for a little bit, I'm going to add some bleach, which I don't usually do. But we're going to do that and see if the magic happens. And if you don't know what the magic is, we'll find out if it happens. So let's very quickly, I'm going to set this back around to the full 10 minute wash cycle. So there. And we'll go. Well, should be about done here. Filling up. There we go. See, it kicks right in. Agitates perfect right away. got about 4 minutes left of agitation, so I'm going to put the bleach in now, and we will see if the magic happens. Too much yet, but maybe. That's kind of doing it. Coming out on camera or not, but the water is kind of turning pink. I don't know what it is about it, but brand new white sheets, if you bleach them the first time you wash them, it turns the water red. Yeah, they're getting there. It's reddening up. Doesn't stain the sheets at all, but I don't know what it is. The only thing I can think of is it might be some kind of reaction. Maybe they use some kind of sizing on the sheets, which is sort of like a starch in the processing of them or the manufacture, and that's what turns red, but who knows? I saw this same thing happen one time on one of Sharky626's videos, a wash day washing with JK18 at Sharky626's place. And I don't remember how long ago it was a year or more ago. And he bleached a set of brand new white sheets and they turned the water red too, so. I didn't put a lot of bleach in, so it's not turning like super red, but it did turn it went from being fairly clear to being kind of murky, then a little bit red. But the agitation's almost done, so I'm not going to add any more to it now, just to see if it turns redder. Just go with where it's at. Like my washer farted there for a second. we go. Just a load of white sheets, nothing too exciting, but just mostly to let you see that the Maytag is still here, and after having an issue, which I thought at one point was going to mean the end of it, and ended up recovering well, and is still working, and is still washing a couple loads a week, so guess that's it for today. Thanks for watching. And if you actually watch the whole thing through in real time, thanks a lot for watching. I must admit, I personally set the speed on washer videos to 2x speed, so I don't have to sit there for an hour watching it. But anyways, thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video. Take care, and have a good evening. Bye.